If you click on this video, then you already know what's up. JJK has taken the world by storm. We see it everywhere when it comes to even Bleacher Report, in sports, and usual anime circles. In today's video, we're going to be breaking down how JJK as a story builds itself up to make itself one of the hypest, if not the hypest anime out there right now. And no, it's not just about Akutami. This is a group effort. We talk about the fandom as well. I'm going to be doing my best to maneuver around the fact that JJK has stellar animation, a great soundtrack. Everything just looks cinematic and pretty. We understand that. We love it for that. But we're going to really, really focus on story structure and how that itself propels us to these hype moments that we see animated and beautiful presentation as we see it. JJK is, of course, above all else, a battle shonen. A lot of the excitement comes from the fast-paced storytelling, the showdowns, and just take a look at the arcs, like the sister exchange, the Shibuya incident, the calling games that is soon to be coming out. It's all fighting. There's no breaks. In some anime, you get these sieges or what leads up to these giant wars and whatnot, but JJK, this is not so much the case. Actually, the format of a lot of the arcs is kind of a battle royale. We're getting 2v2s, 2v1s, 3v1s. Most of the time in JJK, someone is getting jumped by multiple opponents. So when a one-on-one situation does happen, we're more excited for it. And especially when that one-on-one is on equal footing, it feels way more deserved and way more hype. And I think that's the deal. It's not like we don't like seeing Yuji and Toto just like boogie-woogie around an opponent and just, you know, make them go in circles. But at the same time, when it does hit those 1v1 moments, that's, I feel like, a part of what makes them hit harder. And it increases the stakes even more because the numbers game advantage is no longer present. A lot of the times, I feel, in shonen anime and manga, because we're so used to one-on-ones, the stakes aren't as high because it's like, oh, we've been through here. But with JJK, because the one-on-one situations are so few and far in between, when it does happen, the stakes do feel high. Which leads me to my next point. JJK feels kind of like sports writing. What do I mean by that? Well, in things like the NBA and the NFL, storylines just kind of naturally appear. And of course, the media and the production team, it's an entertainment business. They get their money through ratings, guys. They're going to emphasize those rivalries and those storylines that just come up in naturally through the flow of those things. And JJK kind of feels almost kind of the same way, especially with the rivalries. And you could be going like, well, yeah, you know, rivalries are a thing in all shonen battle anime, but JJK takes it to a level of which is like toxic. Like there is, just like the NBA and NFL, there's so much trash talking between the two. Like it's just a player can be the best player in the world and they have one bad performance and the whole freaking like fan base is just like, nah, dude, they're on fraud watch, dude. They're washed, dude. Don't forget he went 0-10. Don't forget he went. Anyways, everyone wants to not people forget that Clay went 0-10 elimination game, but no one wants to remember that Clay had 37 points one quarter, or that, you know, he had however many threes on 11 dribbles. No one wants to talk about that, Clay. I'm gonna miss him. I hope he does well in the Mavs. I'm a little heartbroken, to be honest. I'm not gonna lie to you. But like I said earlier, these 1v1s, when it comes to these trash talking, which behind a hype soundtrack, of course, is gonna go hard with the animation. But when they actually do come, usually it's actually interrupted by an oncoming challenger or the one-on-one. Somebody's isolated from the group, and that's why the one-on-one even happens. Now, those approaching challengers that interrupt the one-on-one, we can call those guys what is basically Deus Ex Machina.
Vox Machina! Fuck! Shit!
Ah! No, not Vox Machina, Deus Ex Machina. It's basically, this happens a lot in fiction, but especially in a shonen series, aka Goku showing up last minute to save his friends. But JJK breaks down shonen troops to his science, kind of like the early seasons of MHA do. Like, for some reason, I feel like the Deus Ex Machinas, when they do happen, like, I don't feel cheated. Like, it feels earned or cool. Like, almost kind of like how fights are sort of orchestrated in the WWE. Look, like, put any clip of Toto entering a fight with a WWE reaction clip, and I swear to you, it fits. It fits to a T.
What?
The prince! 俺たちを覗いてない。
Also, it really does help that the narration is sick. The narrator is a big part of what makes the show hype, in my opinion. I mean, the characters have their one-liners to be sure, yes, but when it makes it into the anime, and they're just given such great color commentary. I mean, Sukuna opens up a malevolent shrine, the narrator is hitting a freaking Mike Breen double bang about painting it on the air or some bullshit. Or like the usual Toji coming through the portal and being like, oh yeah, he like forsake everything or whatever. Like, it's cool. It's cool. Lastly, I think the big thing that adds up to the JJK hype factor is the community itself, the fandom. I'm sure all of us that do scroll on TikTok have seen at least one sick anime edit of JJK in like perfect beat to a rock version of a rap song. For those of you who are not caught up with the manga, do not worry, I'm not going to spoil you here in this moment, but for those of you who are caught up in the manga, and especially have been keeping up with shit on TikTok, I can play this song and immediately, you should know, you are immediately flooded with nostalgia of a certain event that happened over across several months, and this song was in almost every single one of those weeks. The amount of edits that have like an AI doing basically like what the narrator says, or like actually they just have the narrator voice say something that actually wasn't even said in the manga, but then perfectly time it to the drop of a rap rock beat, is like, it just adds a certain thing to the subconscious. Like, when you go back and revisit those moments in the actual story itself, even though that's the rap beat thing is not happening, it like still adds the residuals are still stuck to that moment that I feel like, I don't know, it's like the edit is still there almost. And of course, like every fandom on the planet, the JJK fandom is no stranger to some very low moments where I'm just like, what am I even looking at on my For You page? But we're not going to talk about those moments because this is a video about how JJK is hype. And those things that I saw on my timeline, those things are not hype, they are demented. But I digress. It's just the talented work of the community. But I also feel like the story structure lends itself to being easily edited into these reels such that, you know, characters will say a certain line, and you can add it, just add a little reverb to the character saying the line in perfect timing to a rap beat, and it just works. But yeah, between the sports writing-esque like narrative structure of these like people usually getting jumped, so when we do get to see these one-on-one fights happen with, frankly, a lot of the villains are hateable. Like, I don't think, like, you know, there's an anime out there that have redeemable villains. I hate every single one of these guys. I think that maybe helps out with that, but that plus just the community effort to make cool edits and stuff, plus just the way that you can put things and splice them into a WWE edit and it makes sense with the color commentary from the narrator. I don't know, dude, sports are cool. Just JJK just feels like it has that. And that's all I got on that.